Okay, welcome back again to another Source SDK 101 tutorial for Hammer, of course. And today I'm going to teach you about advanced brushes. So advanced brushes, you know, brushes are, you know, six-sided 3D figure that can be used for anything, like a wall, you know, the floor, anything you really want. But now I'm going to teach you about advanced brushes that, you know, can be cylinders, arches, and other things that are more, that they would be extremely hard to make using just regular, the regular brush tool. So what we're going to do to make an advanced brush, we're going to go over to our block or brush tool, going to select that, and we're going to go down here. See, I have this in this spot, you might have it in a different area, but this is basically your category, and this is for the brush tool. It only appears when you're using that. So right now we want to stay in primitives, we don't want to get out of that. And we want to go to objects, and right now it's a block, which is a six-sided figure. And we're going to want to select anything here. So right now I'm going to show you a cylinder. Now, as you see, this option now became available to us, which is how many sides the cylinder will have. You always want an even number. You don't want something like 25. And the maximum is 32 sides. The more sides you have, the better it looks, but the less sides you have, the less impact it has on your system. So we're just going to create a block, a brush like normal, but we have cylinder selected now, so when we press enter, it's going to create a cylinder. As you can see, it looks extremely smooth because we have the maximum amount of sides we can have for a cylinder. But now you see there are a lot of brushes here, and this has a heavy impact on most systems if you use a lot of these. So if you're ever creating an advanced brush, you're going to want to create it, make it a funk detail. Now, I taught you about funk details in the last video, but if you don't know what that is, if you skip that video or anything, I'm probably going to put an annotation like right up here in the top right corner. So you're going to want to just make this a funk detail, apply, cancel, and there you go. And there's cylinder. Now, you can do this with a lot of different things. There's wedges, torus, spike, sphere, cylinder, the block tool again, and the arch. Now I'm going to do an arch just to show you. The arch is a little bit different than all the other tools, all the other ones. The other ones will be like the cylinder where they're just, you know, you can pick how many sides you want for it and all that. But the arch is different. Now, when you put where you want your arch and you press enter, you're going to get a menu for called arch properties. And now you can change this. This gives you a lot of, you know, tons of options you can pick. Pick the number of sides. Again, you want to stick with even numbers. And when you think you have something you like, you can hit preview and it will show you in this little box. And when you are, and you can press circle to make it a full circle. But when you're done, you can just hit OK, and you'll notice your arch is on the side. So what you're going to want to do, if you want it to be like a regular arch where it's like overhead arch, you're going to want to click here or on any of the sides and then rotate the block to until it lines up good, the numbers are all even, and you can drag that where you want, and it looks pretty nice. So, and you can make this line up here if you want to have like a support beam for it or something. So it looks pretty nice. Now, remember, whenever you're done making these, you always want to go back to the block tool. You don't want to, you know, think you're making a block and end up making a cylinder, so you want to make like a ceiling here and you end up going like this and you're like, oh no, why is this a cylinder? No. So you always want to go back to block when you're finished with the other advanced tools, and you should be good. Now remember to make this a funk detail as well. So, all these. So, I'm going to go over one little thing that I'll probably go over next, but you see all these little dots here. Now, these are all the points. They're actually called vertices. Now, if you're like a modeler or anything, you probably know a lot about vertices, but for anyone that's just starting out, These little points are all vertices, and I'm going to go over them in the next tutorial, so stay tuned. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to subscribe.